Hi everyone, welcome to the second part of .NET Core 3 tutorial series. In this part, we will be learning what are the new things which are available in the .NET Core 3.0. Let's start. So basically, we will be learning what is the latest version of the .NET Core and what new things are available in the .NET Core 3 version. So the latest version is .NET Core 3, which is the preview version as of now. At the time of recording this video, .NET Core 3 preview version is available, and this version was launched on 4 December 2018. If you are watching this video in the future, then definitely you will have the stable version of the .NET Core 3, but as of now, .NET Core 3 preview version is available, and I am using .NET Core 3 preview version for this tutorial series. Now the main point is, what are the new things which are available in the .NET Core 3? So basically, .NET Core 3 is the third major version of the .NET Core release. The first one was 1.0. After that, there were multiple patch releases in the first version. Then the second major version was available in the market, 2.0. After that, there were multiple patch releases in the 2.0 version also. And now we have the third version, which is the 3.0, and which is available in the preview mode right now. So in the .NET Core 3.0, you can use C#7.3, which is the latest version of the C#. So you can use latest C# in your .NET Core 3 application. .NET Core 3 also supports F#4.5 version, so which is the latest version of the F#. So you can use 4.5 version of F# in .NET Core 3, and this is the major change in this release. Earlier, if you know about the .NET Core 1.0 or 2.0, then you know that there was no support of Windows application in the .NET Core, and now in the .NET Core 3 there is a support of Windows application. So you can create WPF applications, you can create Windows Form applications, and the WinUI applications. All of them are now open source and can be used in .NET Core 3 version. Support for local .NET tools using .NET tools.json. So basically, there are multiple commands which you can use in the .NET tool, and you have to use the .NET tools.json. What is that? That we will see in the later part of this tutorial series. As of now, the major changes are, these are the major changes. First one is the latest C#, latest F#, and the main was the Windows application support. That's all in this part. Thank you for watching. Have a great day.